यस सर,
हाँ श्योर सर, थैंक यू। Students, good afternoon all. As a continuation to the moment and locomotion chapter discussion, in the last class we were about to discuss question number 30. So we'll start with the question number 30. Which of the following is the functional unit of muscle contraction? We know that the muscle contraction, it is by the result of sarcomere. Sarcomere, what we call it as the functional unit of muscle contraction or a contractile. It's both anatomical as well as a functional unit of the muscle. So answer here for the question number 30 is B, sarcomere. Now question number 31, recognize the figure and find out the correct matching. So this is again an NCRT diagram. In NCRT moment and locomotion, the structure of muscle bundle, this whole of this muscle bundle is enlarged and trying to show all the parts of the muscle bundle what it is made up of. So question number 31, if you go through here, what they have given, A is the fasciculi or a bundle, what we call muscle bundle or fasciculi. The diagram A, what it shows is the bundle of muscle fiber it is containing, external connective sheet it is having, so it is called as fasciculi. And what about the B is showing the muscle fiber or a muscle cell. In each muscle bundle, we can see that B as a muscle fiber or muscle cell, what we can say. Now, C, if you go through, the C is a plasma membrane of a muscle fiber or a muscle cell, what we call it as the sarcolemma. And D is blood capillary, the capillaries which are supplying blood to the muscle, what we call the blood capillaries are existing. So in a given question 31, if you go through the options A, B, C, and D, among this A, what it says is A is a muscle fiber, it is telling. So this option A is wrong. A is actually what? The bundle of muscle cells are existing. What we can say, muscle bundle or fasciculi. So both B and C are correct statements. So answer for the question number 31 is D. So what is the difference here is that they are called with a different name. Muscle bundle is also called as a fasciculi. That is what they have altered in option B and C. Question number 31, answer is D, students. Both B and C are correct labelings it is showing. Now, question number 32, characteristic feature of a muscle fiber is the presence of large number of parallelly arranged filaments in the sarcoplasm called. We have discussed this question already, students. What they have, contractile proteins, what we call them as a microfilaments, or we also call them as the myofibrils. This is a characteristic feature of a muscle fiber where these contractile protein will help in contraction and relaxation of the muscles. So question number 32, answer is D. Now question number 33, fill in the blanks kind of question it is, students. The first A, the light band contains actin and is called, we know that the light band in the sarcomere, the banding pattern what we read is, light band is called as I band, isotropic band, what we call it as. So one will be in the A, one fill in the blank, one will be isotropic or I band, what we can take. Now B is the thick filament is the thick filament in the sense what we call the myosin. Myosin is also called as A band or held together in the middle. If you imagine the structure of sarcomere, the dark band which is present in the middle, which is held together by a thin M line, that M line what we call the number 3 in the fill in the blanks, what it comes, the M line. So that the thick filament, if you read the statement B, the thick filament in the A band are held together in the middle of this band by a thin fibrous membrane called M line. So statement B is 2 and 3. If you go here is 2 is A and 3 is M line. Now, statement C, in the center of each I band is an elastic fiber called, you know that I bands, both the side I band and elastic lining is present, what we call it as a Z line, Jacques-Tabe, what we called as the Z line, that distance between two consecutive Z lines, what we called as a sarcomere. So in the center of each eye band is an elastic fiber called Z line with which bisects it. So C, fourth one is Z line, what it comes. Now, the central portion of the thick filament, you know that myosin, the thick filament, the non-overlapped part of the myosin is called as H zone, non-overlapped part, the central portion of the thick filament which is not overlapped by the filament is called the H zone. So this whole of question number 33 will explains about the structure of sarcomere, students. So answer for the question number 33 is 1 is I, 2 is A, 3 is M, 4 is Z, 5 is H zone. So answer for question number 33 is C. Now question number 34. Each sarcomere is formed of, as I said, what is a sarcomere? It is a structural and functional unit of a muscle which is responsible for contraction and performing function. We know that when sarcomere is formed of, what it is formed of? Actin and myosin are arranged in a dark and light colored band pattern. And what is sarcomere? Nothing but the distance between two consecutive Z line, what we call it as a sarcomere. So this sarcomere is formed of, what it is formed of? One A band or a thick filament in the center and two off I bands. That is what the options they given is question number 34. First option A, it reads two A bands. It is wrong. There is only one A band is present in a sarcomere. Option B also reads two A band. It is also wrong. Now option C, what it reads is one A band and two I bands. There are no complete two I bands are present. It is wrong. Option C also. Option D, what it reads is one A band and two off I bands. There are two off I bands present in a sarcomere, and in the center, what is the I, two off I bands are forming the light bands. Whereas in the center, what we will see one dark band, what we call as A band. So question number 34, right answer is D, that is one A band and two off I bands are present. Now question number 35, students, read the following statement and find out the incorrect statements. So from question number 35, what you need to find is you need to find the incorrect statements. So what are the incorrect statements? We'll see. Each actin, we know that actin and myosin are contractile proteins, filaments which are responsible for the contraction of muscle. So statement A, what it reads is each actin filament is made up of two globular. We know that, students, actin is made up of polymers. The polymers of what? Actin is made up of polymers. Question number 35, you see. Each actin filament, first option, what it reads is, each actin filament is made up of two G actin helically wound to each other. So we know the structure of actin. Why the statement A is wrong? We know that actin is made up of F actin as a polymer. That F actin is in turn made up of monomeric globular units. Overall, actin filament is made up of F actin, two F actin polymers, two tropomyosin polymer, tropomyosin threads, and tropoins are arranged over it subsequently. Whereas here in the A, what it says is each actin filament is made up of two G actins helically wound to each other. G is a monomeric structure. So statement A is wrong. Statement B, each G actin is a polymer of monomeric F actin, what it is given. So it is the reverse instead, actually. F actin is formed by the polymerization of G actin. So statement B is also wrong, students. Now, incorrect one. Statement C, two filaments of another protein, troponin, also run close to the F actin throughout its length. We know the structure of actin, students. Troponin is made up of three protein units which are arranged discontinuously on a tropomyosin. Actually, tropomyosin is a thread-like structure which will run along the length of the F actin. So statement C says troponin running along the length of the F actin. So statement C is also wrong, students. So question number 35, statement D, what it reads is, in the resting state, subunit troponin mask the active binding sites for myosin on the actin filament, right, in the resting state, subunit troponin units, which will mask the actin binding sites which are present on tropomyosin of the myosin. So this statement D is correct, students. Then statement E is, each myosin has two parts, a globular head with a short arm and a tail. And a tail, what we call it as short arm. Each myosin has two parts, a globular head, with a short arm, heavier myosin, and a tail, lighter myosin. What each myosin has two parts, a globular head. So here, read the following statements and find out the incorrect statements. Answer for the question number 35 here is, students, A. Incorrect statements where we will find is A, B, C. D is a right, and as well as E statement is also right. Each myosin has two parts, globular head with a short arm, and L, that is heavier myosin part. You know that myosin is divided into two parts, that is heavier myosin and lighter myosin. Lighter myosin is comprised of tail-like structure. Heavier myosin has a head region where it contains actin binding site as well as the ATP binding site and an short arm. So question number 35, incorrect statements are found in A. A is the answer, where it shows A, B, C are the incorrect one. Now question number 36, recognize the figure and find out the correct matching, students. Again, it is an NCERT diagram based question, whereas they have given the sarcomere. You need to label the structures of the, this labelings of the sarcomere. We know that the sarcomere is a distance between two consecutive Z lines. You know that the Z line, where it is present, Z line is intercepting the consecutive I bands. So here, the you know, the one statement, one is what it is showing. One is Z line, two is A band, three is I band, and what we have here is four is H zone, and five is sarcomere. You know what is H zone? Non-overlapped part of the dark band, what we call in the middle center with the M line where it is present, it is called as H zone. So where the options they are giving, first A option, what it show is two is I band. It is wrong because two is a band. Now we'll go through the B option. Three is I band, right? Two is A band, correct? One is Z line, five is sarcomere, and four is H zone. So question number 36, students, option B is correct, labelings of the sarcomere. Now question number 37. Heavier myosin component, that is the head of the short arm, project outwards at a regular distance and angle from each other from the surface of a polymerized myosin filament and is known as, you know that at the head of the myosin will be, you can see in the question number 44 picture also is showing, the head of the myosin will be coming out of that polymerized myosin structure for the joining, that is to form a cross bridge with the actin, to bring a contact between actin and myosin, which helps in the contraction of muscle. So question number 37, the head of the myosin which is coming in contact with the actin, where it helps in formation of the cross bridge. So the question number 37, option is C. Now question number 38, the globular head of the heavier myosin is an active ATPase enzyme. Globular head of the heavier myosin is an active ATPase enzyme and has, what are the things we got to find in the head of the myosin? It has two parts. One is actin binding site and second one is ATP binding site. So options they have given is here as follows. A is ATP binding site, right? B, actin binding site in a question number 38. C, myosin binding site. The part of the heavier myosin itself is a myosin. C is wrong. D, troponin binding sites. Actually, it's coming, the head of the myosin, heavier myosin, is going to come in contact with the tropomyosin. then troponin binding site will be wrong. Now E is calcium binding site. Calcium is not going to bind to the head of the heavier myosin. So head of the heavier myosin, question number 38, has a two parts. One is ATP binding site and second one is actin binding site. So answer for the question number 38 here, students, A. Now, if you go through the question number 39, the following statements regarding the muscle protein, one actin, first statement, that is muscle proteins. First, actin is a thin filament and is made up of two F actins. This is right statement. Actin is a thin filament, what we call as isotropic protein, where it is made up of polymers of the G, what we call F actin. Two polymers of the F actins where we're going to find. Now, second statement. Complex protein, tropomyosin is distributed at regular intervals on the troponin. This second statement is wrong with respect to the structure of actin, students. We know that the actin is formed of two polymers. One is F actin, which is given in the first option. Second option, what they are telling is troponin is a polymer. Wrong. Tropomyosin is the two polymers of the tropomyosin, what we're going to find in the actin. And troponins are arranged on the tropomyosin discontinuously at a various site. So statement two, what it reads, complex protein tropomyosin is distributed at regular intervals on the troponin, is wrong. Statement one is correct, students. Now we'll move on. Third statement, what it reads is myosin is a thick filament, which is also a polymerized protein. Yes, myosin is a thick filament. It is formed by the polymerization of monomeric units, such what we call the myosin. Statement 1 and 3 are right, students, here. Now we'll move to the next statement. Fourth one, globular head of the myosin consists of light myosin. Now we know the structure of myosin. The head and cross arm is called as a heavier myosin, and tail is called as a lighter myosin. Here, head is depicted as light myosin in the statement 4. So, statement 4 is wrong, students, because head we're going to find in the heavier myosin. Answer for the question number 39. Among these, the correct are 1 and 3. That is, option is B. First statement and third statement are correct, students. Now, question number 40. Again, it is about the structure of actin protein. Recognize the figure and find out the correct matching. Now, we need to find the labelings. Among the labelings, we should know A is a troponins, B is tropomyosin, and C is F-actin. So, which option will show correctly? A, F-actin in the first option, wrong. Second option, what it shows is B is a F-actin, wrong it is. C is showing, that is option C is showing C is F-actin. And A is troponin and B is tropomyosin. So the question number 40, students, right option, the correct labeling of the actin protein is given in the option C. Now, question number 41, students, component of thin filaments of sarcomere is thin filament. We know that's actin. Actin is in turn composed of, we know that troponin and tropomyosin. So components of a thin filament of sarcomere, myosin is a thick filament. So first option is wrong. Second one, they are showing troponin and actin. Partially it is right, but not showing all the thin filament, thin components here. C is actin and myosin. Again, myosin when it comes wrong, it is. Question number 41. D option, what it shows is actin containing what the troponin and tropomyosin. All these are the components of the thin filament actin. So question number 41, D is the answer, students. Now, question number 42, anisotropic band is made up of. Anisotropic band, what we call it as, the based on the penetration of a light, anisotropic band is nothing but the dark band. Where we're going to see the dark zone, that dark zone is made up of myosin filaments. Question number 42, anisotropic band is made up of only myosin filament, students. So answer for the question number 42 is A, actin filament is a light filament, elastin is not connected with here, anisotropic, what we find is A is the answer. Question number 43, which one is incorporated in muscle fiber? Which one is incorporated? You know, the muscle fiber, nothing but a muscle cell. Inside the muscle cell, what thing we are going to find? Question number 43, first option A, what it says, acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter substance where it is going to be secreted from the neurons in a neuromuscular junction where we are going to find. So, it is not incorporated in the muscle fiber. Now, option B, myoglobin. So, myoglobin is a specialized kind of hemoglobin where we are going to find in a muscle where it helps in transporting gases to generate energy required for the contraction of muscle to show the moment time locomotion. So, question number 43, students, which one is incorporated in the muscle fiber? We're going to find myoglobin is a kind of hemoglobin present in the muscle fiber or a muscle cell. So, the question number 43, B is right answer. Histone, you know, it's a nucleic acid, this what we call it as histone proteins. They are basic proteins found in the nucleus. Cytochrome are proteins where we're going to find in electron transport chain. So, question number 43, answer is B. Now, question number 44. This is again a diagram from the NCERT textbook itself, students. Recognize the figure and find out the correct matching. So, from this figure, we need to find out the correct matching of labelings. What they are given is A, B, C. So, this is what we call it a sliding filament theory where it is given by Huxley and Huxley. This diagram, sliding filament theory, which explains about how the thin filament will slide over the thick filament or how actin is going to slide over the myosin in the muscle contraction. Now, we'll go through here. What are the labelings? First, we'll try to find the labelings in order. So, first, A, if you go through, A is the in the diagram where it shows, A in the diagram, what it shows is, sorry, students. Okay, A in the figure, what it shows is the sequence what we'll find is ATP binds and that ATP will be utilized by the ATP binding site. ATPase activity will break down that energy that will help in formation of cross bridge. Cross bridge is formed in the B. That is labeling what you're given B in the diagram 44 question. Diagram B, what it shows is the formation of a cross bridge. And in the diagram A will show the form the breaking of the cross bridge. And in the diagram C will show the rotation of the actin over the myosin. So question number 44, we need to find the right of options. A, formation of cross bridge, what it shows in option A, wrong it is. Option B, what it shows is C is a formation of cross bridge. This is wrong. Option C, B is formation of cross bridge, right? C is breaking of cross bridge, what they have given, it is wrong, students. Now we will see option D. C is a formation of cross bridge. C1 we will go through. C formation of cross bridge is B. C breaking of a cross bridge and A is they have given rotation or sliding. In a question number 44. Question number 44. C is a right answer. Question number 44. C is the right answer, students. In the diagram B, what it is showing the cross bridge formation. And A is showing the rotation or sliding and C is showing the breaking of cross bridge. So question number 44, answer is C. Now we'll move to the next question. And topic also will change here, students. Topic 3, mechanism of muscle contraction. So, question number 45 in the subtopic mechanism of muscle contraction. Read the following statement and find out the incorrect statements from the following. Question number 45, we need to find incorrect statements. Well, the sliding filament theory states that contraction of a muscle fiber takes place by sliding of thick filament over the thin filament. Statement A is incorrect statement it is, students. Why? Because there will be sliding of thin filament over the thick filament, not thick over the thin, the sliding of actin, that is thin filament, over the thick, that is myosin filament, we're going to see. So the statement A is incorrect. What about the statement B? Muscle contraction is initiated by signal sent by the central nervous system via the sensory neuron. Question number 45, statement B, what it says, CNS is going to send the signal, but not through the sensory neuron, it is through the motor neuron. Sensory neuron will receive the stimulation and motor neuron will send the effect. That is what the function has to be done. The signal is sent through the motor neuron. So B statement is also wrong, students. What it says, the sensory neuron, it is actually motor neuron. Now, question number 45, C statement. A motor neuron along with the muscle fiber connected to it constitute motor end plate, not complete motor neuron. The C statement is also wrong, students. The motor end plate is a part of what we call the motor unit, that is a neuromuscular junction, where it has a nerve endings coming in contact with the sarcolemma of the muscle. So here, question number 45, statement C is also incorrect, students. So in the question, they are asking incorrect statements among the following. All of the above are incorrect statements, question number 45. Now, question number 46. The junction between a motor neuron and a sarcolemma of the muscle fiber is called, the junction between a motor neuron and a sarcolemma of the muscle fiber is called. Just now, as I said here, students, it's what it is called as a motor unit. Motor unit is also nothing but what we call it as a neuromuscular junction. Question number 46. The junction between the motor neuron and a sarcolemma of the muscle fiber is called motor unit or a neuromuscular junction. So question number 46, answer is D. Question number 47, a neural signal reaching the neuromuscular junction releases a neurotransmitter, that is acetylcholine, which generate an action potential in. You know, the acetylcholine secreted or else released from the nerve terminals, which are due to the rupturing of vesicles, so synaptic knobs. These acetylcholine will bind to the receptor present on the muscle. You know, this muscle receptors on the muscle will be present on the plasma membrane of the muscle, what we call it as the sarcolemma. So question number 47, acetylcholine binds to sarcolemma. Option A is correct, students. 47, answer is A. Now, question number 48, during muscular contraction, the myosin head binds to the exposed active sites on actin to form, you know, that the connection, just now what we have seen in a sliding filament theory, the connection between the head of the myosin and the myosin binding sites or troponin parts of the actin, what the cross bridge, what we call it as, this we call it as the cross bridge. So the question number 48, students, during muscular contraction, myosin head binds to the exposed active sites on actin to form a cross bridge so that it can roll over. So answer for the question number 48 is cross bridge, students. Option A, what it says in the 48th question is motor unit. Wrong it is, because neuromuscular junction, what we call it as a motor unit, the end part of the nerve where it is coming in contact with the sarcolemma, what we call it as a motor end plate. Cross arm is a structure of the myosin, the connection developing between the head of the myosin and the part of the actin is called as cross bridge. Question number 48, answer is C, students. Now we'll move to the next question, that is question number 49. Question number 49, in which of the following steps muscle contraction energy is utilized in the form of ATP? In which of the following? In which of the following steps of muscle contraction, energy is utilized in the form of ATP? So that when the energy is utilized in the form of ATP, they are asking during the muscle contraction. When we will find energy is utilized at the head, okay, the ATP binding site of the myosin head will utilize this ATP and help in the binding of head to the actin. That is what we call it as the cross bridge formation. Energy is utilized. Question number 49. Energy is utilized in the form of ATP during what step of the contraction of muscle? Option A, release of calcium ion into the sarcoplasm. It is not energy required because it is the neuromuscular activity. Now, B option, formation of cross bridge is right, students. Whenever the formation of cross bridge between the myosin and actin is taking place, it requires energy. Energy is utilized in the form of ATP. So the question number 49 answer is B, that is formation of cross bridge is the answer, students. Now, question number 50. Question number 50, recognize the figure. This is, you know, that this is again NCERT structure, students. NCERT, you know, the contraction of muscle sarcomere. It is given the same diagram. Question number 50, you need to recognize the figure. What you need to recognize in the figure is, in the given figure, how many sarcomeres are there? You know that sarcomere is a structural and functional unit of the muscle. How many sarcomeres are there in a diagram given in question number 50 is, we know that the sarcomere is formed of, that is, distance between two consecutive Z lines, where it has two of I bands and one A band. Such pattern, what we find in a diagram is that the total of two sarcomere are existing in the question number 50. So answer for the question number 50 is A, that is two. Question number 51, students, read the following statements, find out the incorrect statement. Question number 51, incorrect statements you need to find. What about the A? White fibers has high amount of, you know that the basically the muscles are classified into white muscle fibers and red muscle fiber. So the white fiber has a high amount of sarcoplasmic reticulum, but the number of mitochondria are few. We know that that's the reason the mitochondria existing is less, and what we call the myoglobin existing in this kind of fiber is also less. So this statement A is right. What about the statement B? White fiber depends on the anaerobic process for energy. Because the number of mitochondria are less, it is not utilizing aerobic energy. Most of the time, the energy obtained in the white muscle fiber is anaerobically. So this white fiber depends on an anaerobic process for energy formation. Now, statement C, what it reads is, the reaction time of the fibers can vary in different muscle. Yes, the reaction time in the white and the red fiber, that is, what we will find in a white fiber is rigorously, it is not like very fastly it will function and it will undergo strain, fatigue. Whereas in a red muscle fiber, the reaction time fibers can be slow, but it is consistent, and for a longer period it can perform the function. So question number 51, A, B and C statements are right, students. What about the last statement, D? The process of cross bridge formation, breaking continuous till the calcium ions are pumped back to the sarcoplasmic cisternae, resulting in the masking of myosin filaments. The process of cross bridge formation and breaking continues till the calcium ions are pumped back to sarcoplasmic cisternae, resulting in the masking of myosin filaments. So the calcium ions pumping back, it is required. Statement D is wrong. Why? Because the mask calcium ions will mask the troponin part. Calcium ion is going to mask the troponin part, not the myosin part. Whereas in the statement D, what they have given is, it is showing that it is going to mask the myosin part. So the statement D is wrong from the question number 51. Question number 51, statement D is wrong, students. Question number 52, There are statements are given in a question number 52. Statement 1, A bands are dark and contain myosin. The statement A is correct, student, because what we call A band, nothing but myosin, or also what we call the anisotropic band. Now, statement 2, I bands are light and contain actin. Second statement is also right. I nothing but isotropic band or light band contain actin. Statement 3, during action, A band contracts. Statement 3, what it states is, during contraction of the muscle, A band contracts is a wrong, student. A band always, during contraction, the size of A band remains same. Size of the sarcomere, size of the I band, and size of the H zone in the sarcomere will decrease. The length of the A band remains same during contraction. So question number 52, statement 3 is incorrect. Now statement 4, part between the two Z lines is called as sarcomere. It is a right statement. Statement 5, central part of the thin filament not overlapped by the thick filament. Central part of the thin filament not overlapped by the thick filament is H zone. Wrong statement. Statement 5 is wrong statement, because central part of the thin filament we will not find. Thin filament is I band, where we'll find most of the time it is overlapped or during contraction the most part it is going to be. So the central part of thick filament, which is not overlapped by the thin filament, is what we call it as H zone. So among the following five statements, statement 3 and 5 are incorrect, whereas statement 1, 2, and 4 are correct. So question number 52, options which are showing the right way is C, that is 1, 2, 4 are correct, 3 and 5 are incorrect, students. Now, question number 53, during contraction of muscle, calcium ion attaches to. So the calcium ion, you know, the troponin, the calcium ion secreted by the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Sarcoplasmic reticulum has a, as it releases the calcium ions, where it has three parts. What are those three parts? What we call it as a TI, that is T inhibiting structure, TC, or what we call it as calcium binding structure of the troponin, and troponin T, nothing but the troponin which is going to bind to the tropomyosin. So during contraction of muscle, calcium ion attaches to troponin C. That will initiate unmasking of tropomyosin will take place. Tropomyosin will be get exposed and bind itself to the head, that is actin binding site of the myosin. So question number 53, students, calcium ions attaches to troponin C. Question number 54. Substances that accumulates in the fatigued muscle is fatigued muscle, that is due to vigorous action during the continuous exercise, painful exercise when we will do, we will observe the pain in the muscle after the exercise. Why this pain? The due to the vigorous exercise, the amount of energy required by the aerobic process will be not sufficient to perform. So the muscle will switch to the anaerobic method of getting energy. We know that in anaerobic method, the glucose is broken down incompletely into lactic acid. Accumulation of lactic acid in the muscle will cause us muscle fatigue. So question number 54, answer is B. That is, substance that accumulate in the fatigued muscle is lactic acid. A is given pyruvic acid. This is end of a glycolysis. Pyruvic acid, we're going to find it is wrong. CO2 is also wrong. ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate, is also not formed. Question number 54, answer is B, students. Now, question number 55. Muscle that remains unchanged during contraction and relaxation of skeletal muscle is? Student, as I mentioned just above that, the only filament where it remains constant in the sarcomere of a muscle during contraction is A element, that is A in the sense myosin. This A zone is the size of the myosin remains constant during the contraction of muscle. Now, question number 56. Match the following and mark the correct option. So, question number 56. Match the following. Mark the correct option. What are the following or matching? What we need to do is fast muscle fiber. Fastly performing muscle fiber. What they will show is fast muscle fibers, they will be containing myoglobin. Slow muscle fibers will produce lactic acid. And actin filament is I-band. Sarcomere is a contractile unit. That is A1, B2, C4, D3. Answer for the match the following question number 56 is C, students. Now, question number 57. Question number 57, ATP is needed for muscle contraction is present over. ATP is needed for muscle contraction is present over the myosin, that is myosin head, myosin element of, or what we call as the dark band of the sarcomere. Question number 58, functional unit of the contractile system of a striated muscle is sarcomere. So this is what about from the concept. Mechanism of muscle contraction, students. Now we'll move to the next question, that is skeletal system, topic 4, skeletal system. The remaining questions you solve of the mechanism of muscle contraction, which all are of a similar kind. Now we'll see the topic 4, that is skeletal system. Question number 70.
Sir.
Question number 70. Yes, sir.
Sir, next.
Yes, sir. Huh?
Next.
Oh, okay, sir. Fine, sir. Thank you, sir.
Right, sir.